Sometimes science comes to light that challenges even our most basic assumptions about the universe. But don't fret, standard model of physics. Quantum law will protect us. Da-na-na-da! Hey there, you lovely lumps of degenerate matter. Trace here for DNews. You may remember your schoolbook definition of friction, a resistive force that counteracts the motion of an object across a surface. For example, you can feel friction from the air when you're running and friction from your hands when you rub them together. But if a pulsar is spinning in the vacuum of space, which is full of, well, nothing, then what the heck could be causing friction out there? Hold on to that thought. We'll come back to it. First, we have to talk about neutron stars. These collapsed stars are stellar husks of densely packed neutrons, the tiny particles you find in the nuclei of atoms. They form after a big star goes boom. That's right, when a star of a certain mass, a few times bigger than our sun, runs out of hydrogen fuel and explodes as a supernova, a tiny ball of dense matter only a dozen miles across is left in its wake. Because there's so much matter crammed in such a small space, gravity becomes so powerful that these neutrons are compressed into one of the densest forms of matter possible in nature. This is called degenerate matter. I can't really emphasize enough how dense this stuff is. A shot glass filled with neutron star matter would weigh as much as Mount Everest. A shot glass. Needless to say, these objects are extreme. Stars, just like planets and, well, everything in space, are spinning. Neutron stars retain the spin and magnetic field of their parent star, and often turn into pulsars, which are basically rapidly spinning Uber magnets. Powerful radiation blasts into space from the magnetic poles of the neutron stars, and if, by chance, those poles sweep past Earth as the pulsar spins, we see an intense pulse of radiation occurring at very precise intervals, even though we're many millions of miles away. The pulses are so regular that some astronomers think pulsars are better timekeepers than the most precise atomic clocks on Earth. However, research published in the Astrophysical Journal suggests that there's something slowing the spin of these pulsars, and now we're back to friction in space. You see, the thing with the empty space out there is that it's not actually empty. Even if you could grab a volume of space-time and completely suck out all the particles of gas and dust, the vacuum still wouldn't be empty. It's buzzing with particles appearing and disappearing from our universe. This is known as the quantum vacuum. And after decades of quantum physics theories, scientists have finally realized the quantum vacuum is brimming with what they call virtual particles. Virtual particles are like ghostly apparitions that pop into existence from the vacuum but then immediately vanish. It's kind of freaky. It sounds like this should break some kind of sacred law of physics, right? Well, it turns out these virtual particles appear and disappear so fast that they do nothing wrong in the eyes of the law. Quantum law, that is. Dang, I wish that was a late night science fiction show. I would totally watch it. Though these particles are technically called ghosts, they have a very real impact on space-time and the objects in it. A good example is Hawking radiation. Hawking radiation is a phenomenon which causes black holes to evaporate because these virtual particles pull mass from the black hole. Don't take my word for it, my bae Stephen Hawking says so. And if they can do that, it doesn't seem too large a stretch to think that these virtual particles may also create friction in the vacuum of space, making pulsars slow their spin as they sap them of energy. This happens because the virtual particles may have their own tiny magnetic fields, which could interact with the pulsar's magnetic field, slowing it down. So it's not like friction as we understand it, but these researchers definitely think it's out there. Another question is, can this quantum friction be measured? According to critics of this theory, the friction would be so slight that it probably can't be detected, and other slowing mechanisms might be at play, such as magnetic radiation. That would totally have a stronger slowing effect. But still, it's cool to think that even in the vacuum of space, there may be friction on objects, proving once again just how strange our universe is. Don't take assumptions for granted. When I want to have other people tell me more about space, I like to binge on how the universe works and through the wormhole. I do so right on my phone, and you can too, with Science Go. Watch your favorite Science Channel shows anytime, anywhere. Just download for free at the App Store. What if you were thrown into the vacuum of space? What would happen to your body? Good news? I looked into that right here. The first thing you'd notice as you hit space is the air rushing out of your lungs faster than a sneeze and far more painfully. The tiny alveoli sacs would likely be torn in the process, causing swelling and discomfort, assuming that you had that problem later. Did this episode blow your mind a little bit? Too much? Should we do more of these complex higher level D-newses? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more D-news. We'll see you next time.